Namaste, my name is Rishabh and I'm an architect based out of New Delhi. I'm a LEED AP in Building Design and Construction, and in today's video we're going to learn about Integrative and Iterative Process. So please, I'll explain you the concepts first, so please sit back, relax and understand the concepts, and I will highlight the important things in yellow for you to take down the notes. We have also prepared a practice question bank and the link is in description. I would strongly recommend you to check it out. And this video is part of a social initiative where we are trying to train maximum professionals to help mitigate climate change. So please hit like, subscribe and help us grow. And now let's begin. In today's video, we're going to talk about integrative process and iterative process. So before beginning to understand integrative process, let us get familiarized with the conventional process that happens in most cases. So let's say a client wants to build a commercial tower. He will first hire an architect and ask him to make him a design. The architect will come up with a design after in consultation with the client and prepare a good for construction drawings and cost estimate. The client will invite bids for construction based on the cost estimate and construction drawings provided by the architect and choose an appropriate contractor to carry out the work. The contractor then appoints a subcontractor such as electrical, plumbing, HVAC and other things to carry out the work. So this is a linear, in a very linear fashion. There is no or very poor communication between the contractor, subcontractor and an architect. The subcontractors are not given an opportunity to make a contribution in design, which leaves all the professions in isolation. The process may be efficient, but the isolation usually leads to outcome of the project to be very different than what it was envisioned earlier. Now let us understand what is an integrative process. The integrative process deconstructs the linear nature of the conventional process and establishes a multidisciplinary team approach. In this case, the design team included with the integrative project team is formed before the beginning of the project. So there's a project owner, and the project owner has a project user, construction manager, LEED, AP, architect and contractor reporting to him in an integrative process. Now that you know what an integrative process is, it is important for you to know what a design charrette is. A design charrette is a useful tool when all the project disciplines can come together to identify synergies between project teams, saving time and money in both short and long term while optimizing the resource use and lessening the environmental impact. It is basically when all the stakeholders meet before beginning of the design process. For example, an architect is recommending to use a material which is expensive but environmental friendly. But the contractor, who is also part of discussion, knows the structure cannot be made with that material and recommends a different material which is cheap and also environmentally good. Such practice will help avoid issues in long run and help us save funds and resources. This is just one of the many examples. For now, please remember this, pause the video and take a note of this definition. Now let's move on to integrative process phases. Integrative design process requires active and continuous participation of all the team members during all the phases of the project. The project has been divided into three phases. The first is the discovery phase. It is also called pre-design phase and occurs before starting of the schematic design. This is the most crucial phase of the entire building design process. Team members of each discipline gather relevant data to the project to inform the design process. For example, water calculation can be done before the design begins, as it may help optimize the potable water consumption in the project by informing the design team the size of water treatment plant required beforehand. Similar analysis can be done for waste management or energy management. The second is the implementation phase. During the implementation phase of the integrative process, team members can compile and analyze the result of research performed during the discovery phase, and the design of the building begins to develop through sharing of the collected data. For example, during implementation phase, the project team is asked to review how the energy modeling done initially affected the owner project requirement, basis of design and the design eventually. Now the third phase is the occupancy phase. In this stage, basically the building performance post occupancy is measured and compared with the predicted figures which were calculated in the previous stage. In case there is a discrepancy or the performance does not meet the expectation, a commissioning or an inspection can be done to rectify the issue. Now that you understand the concept, please pause the video and take a note of these integrative process phases. Moving on, so to iterative process. For people who do not know what is the meaning of iteration, it basically means repetition of a process. Now the question is, why would anybody like to repeat things? Isn't that very inefficient? Let us understand this thing by iterative process. The iterative process involves conducting research, sharing data, receiving feedback, and refining a design repeatedly until all the sustainable goals of the project are met. Let us understand that by an example. We plan to go for net zero for our project, net zero water for our project. We calculate the annual rainfall, catchment, and derive the storage capacity required. But as the project moves further, we realize due to climate change, the amount of rainfall remains same, but the intensity of the rain has increased. Meanwhile, the rainfall is still 400 mm a year, but the majority of the rainfall, let's say 300 mm, happens in 1 month. This would mean we need to increase the water storage capacity. So we have to rework the design. Similarly, let's say a client says the building occupancy has been increased from 4,000 to 5,000 people. We would need extra water for those 1,000 people because the water calculation need to be done again. So this continuous process of improving the design, updating goals, analyzing data is called an iterative process. This keeps on happening till the time the project goals are not achieved. Please pause the video and take a note of this exam. Take a note of this for the purpose of your exam. Do not forget to check out our practice question bank, and the link is in the description. Feel free to contact me for any sort of help, and see you on the next video on system thinking. Thank you.